burning oily.
There is some kind of spray nozzles. It's quite clean now.
I'm from Finland. Volkswagen Caravelle Synchro.
I am Sami and I want to be Overlander. It is my ego.
Hello from Wannabe Overlander. In this episode, I'm planning to take off pistons and crankshaft and wash this engine a little bit. Then I'm going to sandblasting this engine block sides and take this to machine shop to check what about. I don't have tools to measuring micrometers or something. And I take this to professional for they can check what I need to do. Do I need to overhaul this or just put the new piston rings and new bearings? So let's disassemble the last parts. The thing to take off the pistons are there is a little bit wear in the bore, so I'm not quite sure can I get the pistons out easy. I take the first one already off before earlier, but it needs to a little bit cleaning to those pistons rings to get over the, those edge. So I need some soft tubing. Perhaps I could use this end of the hammer to push this piston off. I'm scared to I drop it. That's the one thing. I need to put my leg down there. It could go off. Yeah. And you see I'm almost drop it, so I need to be careful with this. So the one piston is off. For me, I'm not the engine specialist. This looks quite nice. A little bit burning oil here, but perhaps with the proper cleaning, this could be usable. So I give the engine shop decide what to do for me, this one. And perhaps I give them cleaning this also. Anyway, for making measurements. In this actually here, I see more wear than the first one. So there is perhaps some kind of wear. I will put this to time lapse and take off the parts. There's probably not much oil anymore. Engine block is clean, but as you see there is a tiny thin rust appears immediately here because I don't have a correct washing solvent, but I think that's not the problem. If I just wipe with my thing, it's already goes off. Then I can cover this and go to sandblasting. Perhaps I need to put some thin film oil to the bearings so they are not get rust. That's not the bearing, but that's the bear housing. I'm a little bit drying with air some holes and that's it. There is some kind of spray nozzles. They spray oil to the piston skirt. So I need to take off this before can cleaning cylinder bores. This kind of nozzle. And we clean this and there is a ball valve. So I'm just put the air. I can take off the dirty oil from the nozzle. Yeah, I make some covering. I use Gorilla tape for masking this. And now I'm going to sandblasting these engine block cheeks and perhaps exhaust manifold. So there is start to raining outside. I can't go sandblasting the engine block right now. So I take off the parts from this intake manifold and probably the oil pan. And I'm going to check if one company can, because I can't clean them, blasting clean and then probably make some kind of coating there, some kind of passivation or something, so it's not get dirty so quick. And the oil pan, I try to wash it very complete, but I can't wash it better. So this piece is fine, just need to clean. If they sell new, I can buy new also, but there is only problem with the dry seal, O-ring seal. Yeah, this one is possible then to clean. You see how dirty it is. You can't get cleaning. I use 0.1 to 0.6 millimeter sand. And this brand is quite good. SPH means seaming and blasting sand. There's lots of noise outside here. Masking this, I'm not going to paint the color to the mounting plank. I'm not sure if this color burn off, is it good for the ceiling, so I don't paint these planks. Just use a scraper. Machining edges are very sharp. Put the masking tape tight and then just go around the edges with the scraper so you're able to take off the masking tape. Simple as this. And then the engine. I'm sandblasted this head also a little bit, but I'm designed to masking this. There is coming some water pumps and something. I'm scared what happens to ceiling if I paint this edge. And same thing, just go with the scraper. Like that. I have a POR 15 engine paint, and this is rust prevent primer. I have this kind of kit, but I'm not going to use this solvent and metal preparing products because I have absolute clean parts now because they are sandblasted. This you can use for the rusted parts. I'm not never want to paint the rusted parts. And this is my engine paint, and this is the rust prevent coating paint directly over rust. They say paint with the brush, but I'm going to try, can I paint this with the spray gun. So let's see. This one I can use this solvent 20% to make it a little bit thinner. Let's see how it goes. I don't ever spray this 415 products with the spray gun. I have my Cadillac engine painted with the 415 engine paint, but not with this gray primer. So I try to spray this exhaust manifold with this. This should stay 250 Celsius heat. So I'm going to spray it here, and if it's burn off, it's burn off.
Actually, this color looking quite nice, and it's absolutely sprayable. I leave it tackle a little bit before I flip it another side. The engine block
not need the second layer, but the exhaust manifold I'm going to put the second layer.
So now this manifold is sticky. It was about 2 hours ago when I sprayed this first layer. So I flipped this over and then I sprayed second time. And the engine block is now ready for the final coating. I flipped this over. I need to do it so I can paint it another side. Okay, now I spray this side and then I flip it over, paint another side.
So, now I have a 415 engine paint.
Then I paint another side and then I leave it drying a couple of hours and then I put the second layer. It's gonna look absolute fabulous. Engine and manifold is painted, but I'm start to tearing a little bit off those maskings, but there is still sand dropping down to the wet paint, so leave it drying. And tomorrow we can take off maskings. Then I have a Sinol and I rinse this piece with the Sinol. So that's it. Now it's Sodablasted and I rinse it with the Sinol. It's some kind of denatured alcohol. It makes some kind of, I don't know what it is, some kind of oxidation surface. So it should not get so quick corroded. So it's quite clean now. I'm happy with this. So the engine block is dry now. I tested with the thinner paint solvent and it's not melting anymore. So I think it's dry enough so they can put this engine block to the washing machine because they use some very strong washing solvent. So I'm going to take this down with this lift and I need to pack some parts, my crankshaft and the bearing blocks and pistons and etc. Then I'm going to take them to the machining shop. So that's the next plan. So perhaps in this video I don't have so much progress. I show you a couple of things. I get the second hand door panel where I can get this right hand side of door panel pocket. So this is nice. And we have give the engine to the machining shop. So they have time now to start to measuring the engine and order parts and check what they need to do for that. So that is some kind of start for that job. And we have a Sodablasted our intake manifold and this, now what was this bracket, power steering bracket or, no, this bracket was the generator bracket, and this one was the power steering pump bracket. We have a little bit setback with this one, but I don't need to mind that because this is not important. But the first time in that company where I get my metal parts to recoating, they have something happens which I'm not quite happy, but they warn me. They say, you never know when this cast aluminum parts have happened something like this, so they get the gray color. So this is not the pure aluminum, so this might be some kind of zinc aluminum alloy casting, so that's why the color changed. But it's never mind. Perhaps this is not get the corroded anymore because there is this coating. And the same one happened to this oil pan. So this is actually quite rude now. They didn't clean this well because we think about this dirt can go off here when they clean it with the bath, but it wasn't. So, but this is just the oil pan. And you could not see this in the car when the car is done. So there is not much something. We get the engine block painted, also sandblasted, and now we're waiting what happens for that. And meanwhile, the engine is in the engine shop. I could take the fuel pump also to rebuild. And we have lots of things to do in the car body. So I'm gonna end this video here. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and remember, it costs nothing.
Thank you for watching, and see you in next episode.